Hey there, Toby Lipinski for the New England edition of the Fisherman Magazine. In this week's video fishing forecast, we got an update for you on the Fisherman Magazine subscriptions, details on the July print issue, an update on the 2020 Niantic Shark Week, good catches of black sea bass and fluke in Massachusetts and Rhode Island waters, some big bass being caught off of Montauk, and your weekly update to the Coastal Kayak Clash leaderboard. Let's check it out.
The fishing news is sponsored by these fine partners.
Hey there, Toby Lipinski for the New England edition of Fisherman Magazine. I want to wish everyone out there a happy 4th of July holiday weekend. Hopefully you're going to get a chance to get out and fish a little bit, and you're checking in here today to see what's going on to help direct you where to fish this weekend. But before I get into that, I want to begin with an official announcement. It actually appeared in the July print issue of the Fisherman Magazine, but kind of paraphrasing it here. We've made a couple of slight changes to the subscription format for the Fisherman Magazine. Now, as many of you know, on-time delivery of the weekly newsprint magazine has been a bit of a challenge for some time now due to a number of uncontrollable factors. Now, in the interest of providing subscribers with the timeliest information, we changed our subscription model a little bit. Home delivery of our 12-monthly glossy magazine print issues will continue to be delivered to your home every week, as well as your local newsstands. However, the weekly newsprint issues, the weekly report supplements, will no longer be printed and mailed. Instead, they will be published as a digital-only magazine version available at thefisherman.com. Now, this has kind of been our format since back in April when we returned to the weekly print status, so you should already be pretty well accustomed to it by now. Of course, again, thefisherman.com, sign into your account. If you've had any issues or concerns with getting in, if you need a little bit of help getting into your account, you can call our customer service every single weekday from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. That's 866-347-4836. They'd be more than happy to help you. And of course, those weekly issues, weekly, monthly, all of them are available every single week by 2 p.m. on a Monday at thefisherman.com. You also have access to the archives of the digital library as well as access to the other editions beyond just that edition which you subscribe to. So if you subscribe to New England, you also get Long Island and New Jersey Delaware Bay available electronically. So head on over to thefisherman.com and check it out. Speaking of that print magazine, the July issue is out this week, hitting newsstands as well as your mailbox any day now. And it has been live, of course, at thefisherman.com since Monday afternoon, as previously noted, so those of you accessing it digitally have a jump on reading it. Now, this month's issue has an update on the 2020 Northeast Tag Study, in which we deployed two satellite tags into a pair of very large striped bass a couple of weeks ago, so we get all the details on that. We got an update on the chub mackerel that have been invading southern New England the last couple of years. Now, they make great sport, great bait, as well as great table fare, so we got you completely covered on the ins and outs on the chubs. We got some deep water fluke tactics, ways to fight off the summer doldrums in the surf for big striped bass, targeting big summer black sea bass, and of course much, much more. So check it out right now, whether digitally at thefisherman.com or your hard print issue for your subscription arriving at your mailbox or in newsstands this week. And I got one more quick housekeeping note before I get into those reports. Last week, if you recall, I was down in Niantic, reporting live as the 2020 Niantic Shark Week presented by the guys over at J&B Tackle was scheduled to kick off this past weekend. Now, unfortunately, shortly after I shot the video and the video went out, they had to make a tough decision to postpone for 1 week. Now, a lot of stuff has been delayed this year because of concerns with COVID-19, so they weren't able to quite get everything together the way they wanted to in order to produce the best possible tournament for you. So they just push it off 1 week. It kicks off July 4th, and it runs through July 12th. If you're already signed up, you're automatically continued over by the 1 week. And if you didn't get a chance to sign up last week, it gives you a couple extra days to sign up. You would head on over to TriState. shootout.com for complete details on all the initial entry, to sign up, to get in on all the multiple Calcuttas, and all of the information is available right there. And as far as the tournament itself, they're not doing a live captain's meeting this go-round. Instead, they're going to provide a video for everyone who is participating with all of the information that they're going to need. So that will be sent out. You'll be able to access it yourself and view it at any time. And of course, you can go get your captain's bag either July 2nd or 3rd at J&B Tackle itself right down there in Niantic. So check it out. We got all the details available right now. News story at thefisherman.com. Or you can just head right over directly to tristateshootout.com as well. Okay, jumping into the reports. We're going to start off up in Massachusetts, where the sea bass bite is still going strong. Everybody that I've talked to up there is still getting into some really good fish. Lots of limits being had. If you recall last week, I had a picture of Brooke Angel. That's Greg Angel's daughter. She had a really nice fluke as well as a big black sea bass. Well, this week it's his wife, Lorraine, who gets in on the video and the fishing forecast for us. She got a really nice pair of big black sea bass. That is obviously a very talented fishing family. They've been featured multiple times here in my videos as well as in print. If you want to get in on it, of course, you can send me your reports, your photos, your videos, what have you, directly at tlipinski@thefisherman.com. I would love to add your reports and photos and videos into an upcoming report as well. Still up in Massachusetts for the past couple of weeks, my buddy Captain Jason Colby of Little Sister Charters has been working on the winter flounder and the haddock up in the Boston Harbor and nearshore areas. Well, it's time for his annual migration down to Westport, Massachusetts, where he is going to be for the rest of the season. Now, he arrived there a couple of days ago, has already gotten in on the sea bass, but it's not just sea bass he targets. He goes for fluke, sea bass, striped bass, albies when they show up. He does blackfish in the fall. He does some offshore trips. He runs out for cod and mahi. Whatever bite is going on, Jason's going to get you in on it. And that Westport area is a great jumping off point to get into a lot of different fish. So if you want to find out what Jason's got for availability to get in on either a private charter or one of his open boat trips, drop him an email. His email address is fishinglsister@aol.com. Be sure to razz him a little bit as being one of the last guys still using an AOL account, and then he will get you all that information. Jason comes highly recommended. I fished with him a bunch of times. Really good captain. So give him an email and see what you can do. And then moving on down into Rhode Island. Last week I reported that finally black sea bass season opened up in Ocean State, and those sea bass and fluke combo trips are paying off big time right now. Private boaters are doing well, and of course the for hires are getting in on, and the charter boats are another great way to get in on this bite. 7B's, Francis Fleet, both reporting really good action. They're running full day trips, they're running half day trips, they're getting in on the action on every outing. They are reporting as well, that they consistent bite throughout, but they've been having flurries of really hot action, especially on those sea bass where the fish just start coming over the rail. For whatever reason, they turn on different stages of the tide, and it hasn't been the same exact stage from day to day, but nonetheless, they are doing really well, both off the beaches of South County as well as out around Block Island. The bite has been pretty good inshore. Rhode Island field editor John Hanasek was out this weekend. He had, I think it was 6 keeper fluke on Saturday, got back out on Monday, had another 4, mixed in some sea bass, had some what would have been keeper blackfish even mixed in had the season been open. So some really good action, and those were just pretty close to shore. So some good options for you there. And also in Rhode Island, heard from Steve Bender. He got in touch with me through Facebook as he and his son Logan were working just off those South County beaches over the weekend for fluke. And Logan was a high hook on the day with a hefty 24-inch fish that he landed on a simple bucktail jig and 6-inch gulp grub combo. Now, they had some other fish throughout the day, pretty steady action the whole time, a bunch of short fish thrown back, and by the end of the day, they iced 7 solid keepers for the duo, a solid trip nonetheless for the South County beaches right now. And then moving on into Connecticut, Captain Greg of the Blackhawk has been, he started his night striped bass trips recently, and he had some slammer trips last week with multiple 50 pounders. Thursday nights had a pair of 52s, a bunch of fish in the 40s, a load of fish in the 30s. Of course, any fish over the slot of 28 to 35 inches was released. That's right, there is a slot limit in place for striped bass this year. I've been reporting it for quite some time. You should be well aware by now, but in case you're not, anything under 28 inches must be released. Between 28 and 35, you can take it home. Once it hits or exceeds 35 inches, it's got to go back. And of course, all those big fish that they got on the Blackhawk were released last week, and they only kept the ones within the slot, and they had a lot of them in that range too. So we went home with a lot of happy customers, both putting a couple of nice fillets in the cooler as well as releasing some big breeder fish to continue with it. And like all of the party boats right now, whether it's Mass, Rhode Island, Connecticut, New York, wherever you are, reservation only because of the restrictions with COVID-19. You got to do the pre-registration. You can't just show up and go on the boat. So with Blackhawk, it's blackhawksportfishing.com. They got their complete schedule. You can reserve your spot, pay for it, take care of the whole deal right there online and be all set. And I will advise, get in on it soon. If you want to get out on any of the boats, regardless of where you want to sail out of, do not delay. I heard from a couple of my friends that were trying to get out this past weekend. It was a last minute decision and they weren't able to do it because all of the spots had been sold. So do not delay if you want to fish from the party boat this weekend. And last up this week, we got an update on the Coastal Kayak Clash Fishing Tournament. This is, of course, your chance to win a brand new Old Town Sportsman Series Autopilot 136, complete with a Minn Kota trolling motor, as well as a bunch of other great prizes from sponsors, including Humminbird, Penn, Fenwick, Yak Attack, Yak Lights, and many, many more. Now, you can head over to thefisherman.com right now, select Coastal Kayak Clash from the drop-down at the upper left-hand corner to get all of the details on the tournament, as well as to register. And as to that leaderboard, we didn't have a whole lot of changes or movement this week. We did have a couple of notable entries come through nonetheless. We had a new top fluke. It's a 28-incher landed by Robert Wagner out in Jersey. We got a new third-place fluke of 24 inches landed by Brian Bollerman of New York. We got a new second-place weak fish of 23.5 inches landed by Chris Dardzinski of New York. Now, Massachusetts angler Justin Oser, still holds that top spot on the leaderboard with 13 total points made up of the top scup, second place fluke, the top sea bass, second place bluefish, and the biggest blackfish. Now, while he holds a pretty good lead right now, there is plenty of time for you to get in on it and get in the leaderboard, because while the tournament did start back on May 1st, it runs through the end of May. So all you got to do, be a subscriber in good standing, sign up, register your account, no additional charge, and then get out there and start fishing off of your kayak, and you'll have a chance to win any of those awesome new prizes. Of course, all of the details and to register can be found right now at thefisherman.com. All right, well, that's it for this week. You can check out all the fishing reports for the week from New England through the Mid-Atlantic right now at thefisherman.com. And please be sure to like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and tap the bell to be notified instantly when we post a new video. So until next week, have a happy 4th of July holiday weekend, and tight lines if you head out onto the water this weekend.
Steigercraft boats, built by people who fish our waters. Serious anglers choose Steigercraft for their 40 years of boat building experience right here in the Northeast and Mid-Atlantic. Visit Steigercraft.com for a dealer near you.